Judy.
Yes?
A quick word association.
Okay, I'm ready.
Grass.
Green.
Sky.
Blue.
Dahlias.
Beautiful.
Garden time.
Coming up next. Welcome to Garden Time. We're at Swan Island Dahlias in Canby, and it is their festival. As you can see, we're surrounded by dahlias as far as the eye can see. It's a great event, and the best part is that it's a free event.
In fact, later on in the show, I'm going to be talking to Heather about the colors that are their top sellers and how you can get them for yourself.
Also coming up in the show, I'll be at Timber Press and seeing some of their new summer books.
But coming up first, we're going to tell you how to deal with those pesky summer wasps.
This time of year, you may notice wasps or yellow jackets hanging out in the garden. We're at our producer's house and we noticed a nest that's right in this sword fern right here.
And you know, it's not that these things aren't beneficial to the garden, they can be. However, when they're right by a path like this, every time you brush by the ferns, you're gonna disturb them. And if you are allergic to any kind of sting, it can really be rather dangerous.
So we're gonna take a ride over to a local garden center and find out just what they have that you can take care of this pest.
So, you know, we are out at Al's in Woodburn, and I'll tell you, this is some of the great stuff that you can really find at almost any independent garden center, but this is stuff we've gathered together to share with you about how you can control wasps and yellow jackets in your own gardens.
Well, the first thing we found were these traps or lures from rescue, and these you kind of hang around your picnic area by your patio, and there's actually a lure that is in these packages that you put in, and it attracts the wasps or the hornets and keeps them away from you. And they're made out of pheromones that actually bring them away from the people, and so they're not going to bother you. And the good thing about these pheromones is that they attract only the wasp or the hornets. They don't attract honeybees, which we really want to protect. And you know, if you have these from last year, you can buy these as extras, so you don't have to buy the containers every year. We also found a more decorative kind of trap. This is kind of pretty. It's almost ornamental for your patio. And they do have the same kind of lures, or you can even use a piece of meat. You know, if you have that old salami in the fridge, you could put that in, and they really are attracted to it.
You know, Judy, there's also some other options, which if you look at these spray cans, there's a couple different types of sprays that work very well. Now, a lot of times we want to stay away from the nest because a lot of us are allergic to them. So ones like this one right here actually have a pretty far reach to them. Just read the instructions on the back and follow that label, but you can just shoot it up there. If it's a high nest or if it's even a low one, you can stand back and really get some safety. This one is a foam, which is really nice because you can see where it's going specifically, and the directions again are on the back, but you just want to hit the nest and really fill it in. Even if they start coming out, you just keep covering it, and then you know it's best to walk away. Now, with almost all of these sprays, the best time to apply is in the evening, and the logic there is that everything's coming home to nest for the night, so that makes good sense. And we also wanted to discuss one last thing, and that is bounce dryer sheets. Now, a lot of people really believe in these, and they are used as a deterrent. So, you know, we don't really advocate killing off wasps and hornets and stuff, but if they're in the area where you're entertaining, they can be rather dangerous to people that are allergic to them and just painful. So we want you to enjoy your gardens. Go to any of the garden centers and look for this kind of stuff to find out which product is going to work the best for you in your garden.
Garden Time is brought to you by Portland Nursery, a passion for plants, a nursery for plant people.
Do you want to be green? Do the easy stuff first. Hi, I'm Sarah from Portland Nursery. The U.S. House Energy and Commerce Committee says for every dollar spent on a shade tree, you can save $5 on cooling, blocking the penetrating heat in the summer and allowing the warm rays through in the winter. Dollar for dollar, there's no better energy and money saver than a good deciduous shade tree. Portland Nursery's professionals can help you make the perfect selection. Portland Nursery, a passion for plants, a nursery for plant people.
The dahlias are blooming and the fields are open. Stop by Swan Island Dahlias in Canby and stroll the 40 acres of blooms. And don't forget the Dahlia Festival the last weekend in August and Labor Day weekend. During the festival, you can see over 400 cut flower displays, enjoy specialty foods, and see flower arranging demonstrations. While you visit, you can also order your favorites for next spring. visit the Swan Island Dahlia Farm in Canby, just 30 minutes south of Portland.
If you build it, build it right. Build it to last. Don't just build it for yourself. Build it for the next generation. Build it with Par Lumber. And keep building the Great Northwest.
Par's deck sale is going on now with TimberTech starting at $219, Trex $229, and Cedar at $139 per lineal foot. While supplies last, visit par.com for details.
So I'm standing in the fields of Swan Island Dahlias. It's one of my favorite places to come at this time of year because of all the beauty, and I'm here with Heather. And so Heather, we are going to be talking about, really, these are the top colors which sell, aren't they?
They are. We have just gone crazy, or brides are going crazy, with the request of how much they want of these color tones.
So let's start over here on this one here. Tell me about this group, and what are the names of them, and why do you think they're so popular?
Oh, I think it's that dreamy, romantic, soft, beautiful wedding colors. I don't know. I think it's that pastel. I say dreamy. I don't know.
Well, it is. It feels like a very old-fashioned looking group of colors.
I would definitely agree. So this is one of the most sought-after peaches. It's called Touché.
Wow.
This is one of the big guys, but Papagino is its name, and I think it's kind of got all the combos of the pinks and the peaches.
It does, and up close you see it's almost got a stripe in the petals with all of these different colors.
A lot of texture to it. This is Jitterbug, and you know what? Coral is a really hard color, but most brides that are going for coral are going in and loving this variety.
And with that smaller size, that'd be great for boutonnieres as
well. Yeah, it kind of goes everything, table centerpieces to boutonnieres. This is Dreamcatcher, one of the new introductions last year.
Beautiful.
Gorgeous. Uptown Girl.
That's a little darker, but I like
that. It is. And it changes a lot with weather. It's one of the ones we see the most color change with hot weather versus cold weather. It gets a lot deeper and darker in the cool weather and a lot softer.
And so is that all the colors, or just like the burgundies?
Everything.
Or
it's everything. Nice. Just kind of across the board. This is Peaches and Dreams. Dreamy. People want it. It's highly sought after every year for bulbs in your yard or to have for events or weddings.
Uh-huh.
This is Sheer Heaven, another one that kind of just that
it does,
mix.
It's
kind of pinky
They're
peach.
All different shades of these colors, aren't they? Yeah, lovely. How about this?
Chilson's Pride is just that soft baby pink, and it gets a little bit more white as it opens and gets older, so it softens up even more. Down in the front, that's Gabrielle Marie, and I actually named it after my daughter. I fell in love with it a long time ago, and I still love it. And then in the very front, there is Innocence. It's that big, gorgeous, soft pink, and it'll get much bigger as it opens and gets older.
You know, what I like about all these colors is that they're not colors unto themselves. They can really blend with a whole variety of different shades.
And we have so many people coming to us saying they don't like this because they see yellow in it. Well, you kind of lose the yellow when you start to combine them with more. You know, if you put it with yellow, of course it's going to draw the yellow out, but sometimes mixing with the other colors tends to just fade that yellow.
It fades it out. Now, I tell you, this we saved till last because what a beauty, and this is all one type of bloom. This is one variety.
This is called Cafe au Lait, and the blooms on the plants are anything from this soft pink to more of a peach to a real kind of just creamy blush.
You guys can't keep this in stock, can
you?
No,
we can't. We're sold out for the season in cut flowers. It is outstanding in the sense of what people want for their wedding bouquets, that look.
Yeah.
It's what you see online everywhere. Still have bulbs to purchase for next year, but we're sold out of the cut flowers.
Well, and speaking of bulbs, it's that time of year for
it
the festival
is,
here,
yeah.
And you can get them 10% off if you come out here or go online to buy bulbs, right?
Correct. Now through September 7th, we have a 10% off going automatically if you place your order in person or online.
Nice. And tell me about this festival, because each year it's a blast.
We love it. It's free for you to come, free to park, free to get in and enjoy the fields. There's over 40 acres to view and walk through. There'll be over 400 floral arrangements indoor to see. You can learn how to divide your dahlias. So if you're growing them and want to multiply your own product, you can do that. You can learn to flower arrange. There's wine, beer, food, and live music. from noon to 4.
And this is not a Friday, Saturday, Sunday event.
No.
This is a Saturday, Sunday, Monday event.
Yes, exactly. And it's 10 to 6
perfect,
on those days.
Perfect. Well, you know, to feed all of your senses, be sure you make it out to this event. It's always beautiful, always fun. For more information, we invite you to go to gardentime.tv. We'll click you over to the website. Heather, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Garden Time is brought to you by Capital Subaru, your way on the parkway.
Based on reviews, I found Capital. It was an excellent experience. I felt very comfortable, especially being a single woman.
Play more this summer. Right now, save $4,000 off MSRP on the new 2015 Subaru Forester 2.5i Touring CVT and IIHS Top Safety Pick. Make no payments for 120 days.
When I hear stories from other people about car buying experiences, they're horror stories. And mine, I just left with a big smile and I've been smiling ever since. I got it my way on the parkway.
Garden Time is going to Ireland. Join William and Judy as they tour the Emerald Isle, visiting some outstanding private and public gardens. For more information, go to gardentime.tv and click on the airplane.
Stop and smell a rose, hear a child laugh, see the beauty that is Oregon. You will find all this and more at the Oregon Garden in historic Silverton. 400-year-old oaks, edible landscapes, a children's garden. The Oregon Garden has something for everyone. You can ensure the garden remains a jewel in the Mid-Willamette Valley through your support as an individual, family, or corporate member. Support the garden that showcases the diverse botanical beauty of our state, the Oregon Garden.
Portland is so lucky to have a book publisher right in our town. I'm with Tom Fisher from Timber Press. Good morning.
Good morning, Judy.
You know, we love coming down because you always have a great selection of books. So we have a whole stack, so let's just talk about all of them.
Sure, sure. So one of our latest is The Indestructible Houseplant by Tova Martin. Tova is one of the country's foremost houseplant experts. And the thing about this book, it's for all you people who think you can't grow a houseplant. If you think you've got a brown thumb, it will show you you don't. The plants, there's some familiar ones in there, some new and exciting ones, but she'll tell you exactly what to do to keep them alive. And the other fun thing about the book is that Tova shows all sorts of interesting upcycled objects you can use containers, colanders, old pots, old dishes, all sorts of things, and all these kinds of creative combinations that are really fun and funky and will look great in your house. And she tells you all the practical stuff as well about potting, watering, disease prevention, and so it's a great one book package.
And so we don't have to have silk plants, we can't have real
plants. Nope, you can't have real plants.
And then projects, you know, it's getting to be fall and we really would like to have some projects. Do it yourself.
Sure, and a lot of people like to do things like this. Concrete color projects, concrete color garden projects, is about all these nice little projects you can do at home with materials you can find either at Home Depot or the hardware store. They're really, really easy and they're really fun. Things like little containers and planters for your deck, house numbers, street numbers for your house, a little table for your deck, a little chair for your kids, and they're easy. You buy the concrete, you buy the materials. You can either buy pigment to stain the concrete or you can stain it afterwards, and it shows you step by step exactly what to do to make all these fun objects.
I do like the pictures. It has a lot of good step by steps and really some inspiration here. This is beautiful.
Yes. The Art of Gardening is about the Garden Chanticleer, which is a public garden in Pennsylvania, really one of the most creative public gardens in the country because they allow all the individual gardeners to do whatever they want in each area. So this book is filled with inspiration for things you can do in your own garden. It's not just things on a large scale, plant combinations for different kinds of conditions, sun, shade, water, containers, all sorts of things. As you go through and look at the gorgeous photos, you'll really be inspired to do things in your own garden.
And really going into fall, this is the time that we need that inspiration for our own gardens.
Yep, yep. And Seeing Seeds is with photographs by photographer Robert Llewellyn and text by Terry Chase is a beautiful armchair book with these stunning close-up photos of hundreds of different kinds of seeds. And the text text is very engaging and fun to read. Terry tells you about all the reasons that seeds look the way they look and why they do the things they do. And meanwhile, you're being entertained by these gorgeous, gorgeous close-up photographs.
Ah, so educational and beautiful, too.
Both, yes.
And there we have two now that are kind of like sister books.
Yes. Yeah. This is, you know, we're getting into fall and the rain is going to be coming back. And a lot of Northwest gardeners have shade in their garden. Mm. So ferns and moss are two things you can do in a shady garden that really make it look wonderful and that are suited to our climate. Our book on moss gardening, by The Magical World of Moss Gardening by Annie Martin, shows you how to cultivate moss to encourage it instead of trying to get rid of it. I know we try to get rid of it on our
right,
roofs.
Why be frustrated?
But in the garden, it can look wonderful.
Sure.
And there are different kinds of moss. There are different things you can do with it to create a sort of very serene, almost Asian kind of landscape, which can be very, very beautiful. So why don't we just encourage it instead of trying to fight it?
Sure. And then ferns.
And then ferns. Ferns are a natural for our climate. I mean, everyone knows what sword ferns look like, but there's so many other choices. And so this book has an encyclopedia of all the hardy ferns that are great for our region, as well as lots of design ideas about what you can do with them in shady gardens, combining them with other foliage textures and shrubs to create these really beautiful tableaus of beautifully textured foliage. So it's a great resource for anyone who's got any kind of shade in their yard.
Right. With fall coming, it's great to have a book for inspiration or for that do-it-yourself project that you've been wanting to do for your garden. You can go to Timber Press to get the ideas of where you can get these books or go to your favorite booksellers. Tom, thanks so much.
Thanks, Judy.
For our tip this week, it's all about saving water. So for tonight's dinner, we just steam some vegetables. So what we're going to do is save that water and to use in the garden. You know, that water is going to be nutrient rich because of the vegetables. So all we're going to do is let it cool down and then we're going to come out to the deck and add it right to the pots. So saving water and adding nutrients to the plants, that's our tip of the week.
Now's the time. Standard TV and Appliance Labor Day Sale going on now.
Huge price cuts on top brand appliances, mattresses, and HD TVs. Save big on a Samsung front load washer with steam, $629. Get a Whirlpool stainless steel French door refrigerator, only $1,224. Huge savings on a stainless steel Frigidaire dishwasher, only $299. Plus, get a Beautyrest queen mattress for just $349.
Hurry, Labor Day savings won't last long. Standard TV and Appliance.
The dahlias are blooming and the fields are open. Stop by Swan Island Dahlias in Canby and stroll the 40 acres of blooms. And don't forget the Dahlia Festival the last weekend in August and Labor Day weekend. During the festival, you can see over 400 cut flower displays, enjoy specialty foods, and see flower arranging demonstrations. While you visit, you can also order your favorites for next spring. Visit the Swan Island Dahlia Farm in Canby, just 30 minutes south of Portland.
Transform your home and garden with help from Garden Gallery Ironworks. From garden structures to home decor, we can help you refresh your indoor and outdoor living spaces. Decor that is exquisite and unique. Garden Gallery Ironworks makes your home and garden attractive, appealing, and a relaxing place to stay. Inspired designs that are locally made. Garden Gallery Ironworks, located in the Hubbard Industrial Park off 99E. Look for the amazing petunia tree.
So I am here with Aaron at the beautiful Oregon Coast Aquarium in Newport, and one of the things that I think is fascinating about this beautiful place, Aaron, is that it hasn't been around for a long, long time, first of all, which I think a lot of us think, oh, that's been around for 50, 60 years. And not only that, but it came from a very humble beginning, didn't it?
That's right. The aquarium just opened in 1992, so we're currently approaching our 25th anniversary. Not quite there yet.
Uh-huh.
The aquarium was established by local community leaders who wanted to give families and travelers a reason to visit Newport and the Oregon coast.
Uh-huh.
And so this was a true grassroots effort that's bloomed into something I'd like to think is quite beautiful.
It is quite beautiful. And so, first of all, I think it's always delightful and fascinating when a community can come together and create something like this.
Absolutely.
And then they created it from again, really humble beginnings, because it wasn't this when they came up with the idea, was it?
No. This land was owned by the port. And in the 1950s, this was a mill. I'm not sure when the mill closed. However, by the 1980s, when they started planning for the aquarium, it was abandoned. And so what you see here is this naturescaped landscape, exhibits, artificial rock work, and these meandering pathways. Yeah. But back then, it was sand dunes, non-native invasive plants, and a fair amount of abandoned industrial equipment. Wow. So it's come a long way, and we hope that what we have here and the native plants we have here inspire our visitors to get outside and try some of the things they see in their own gardens as well.
Well, and that is one of the things that I really love about this place, is that it actually has, it's almost every plant that's in this area is a native plant that's been grown right here. So it really brings it back to Newport and Oregon.
Right. Our aquarium isn't just about fish. We interpret coastal species, yep, birds from the sky, marine mammals along the coast, and we love to showcase the beautiful green wonder of Oregon coast.
Well, and like any great park or a place where you can take your family, you guys also do all kinds of different events and different exhibits and stuff.
That's right. So we currently have our special exhibition, Secrets of Shipwrecks, Part History, Part Mystery.
Nice.
And it's all about underwater archaeology. So it lets our visitors dive into the little known world of marine and freshwater excavation, and draws attention to the fact that some of the world's best and most untouched museums are underwater.
Wow.
So we hope to inspire the next set of marine scientists
to get some passion and want to go forward with that.
Yeah.
And then where would people go to find out like what's happening and what's coming up and the exhibits? Where do they go for all that?
Aquarium.org, our website, is one of the best places to check out what's new and upcoming events at the aquarium. They can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram,
wow,
or
you
our
guys
blog.
Are out there, aren't you? On your
we
blog.
We are.
Too.
We're everywhere.
That's wonderful.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I love this place not only because it gives you an animals that you can look at that are in this area, but it also inspires gardening because it shows you the beauty that can come from our native plants if you do them correctly. Plus, they give education. It's just a great place. So get the family together. If you live in the Portland area or any place in the valley, come on over, spend the day here, and just really enjoy it. For all that information about what they have going on, go to gardentime.tv. We'll click you over to their website. Erin, really appreciate it. Thank you so
much. Thank you so much for stopping by.
It's a beautiful windy morning, and I'm in Monteverde, Costa Rica with Victor. And Victor, you are a part of a wonderful conservation organization. And what is that company, that organization?
The name of the company is Fundación Conservacionista Costarricense. And it was created in 2000, and the idea is to protect the forest or habitat on the Pacific side of the Continental Divide.
And Monteverde is very special because many years ago, actually a group from the United States came here.
Yeah, that was long, long time ago, 1951. A group of Quakers from Fairhope, Alabama, came here and started with this private conservation effort for 1,500 acres. Then eventually they gave it to a private organization in Costa Rica, Tropical Science Center. And from right there, it started this huge effort of conservation in Monteverde.
And it's really so special because it is all privately owned. It's not governmentally administered or anything.
Nothing. Everything belongs to the families, basically, and private organizations, like Children's Eternal Rainforest. That's from Monteverde Conservation League here in Monteverde. There runs that.
And people still can go through. Like, we went through hikes and we got to see so many beautiful things. And really, your organization is doing things for the flora and the fauna here. But why is it important for everyone to know, for people even in Oregon to know about this special place?
Our effort that is based on the Pacific, it plays a really, really good role because the Pacific side was pretty much cut off, pretty much devastated. All the forest disappeared. A lot of the forest disappeared on the Pacific. And the big connection between here and Oregon, even when we are so far away, are the migratory birds.
Oh.
Yeah, there are a lot of migratory birds that come right here to this area. And we carried a project for a few years where we were catching migratory neotropical birds. And that way we knew what they were doing, which ones were coming right here. And our birds that go all the way to Oregon. Oh. So, and they do it twice.
Wow.
They go down south and they come back in April. So this is with habitats, with patches of forest like this, they play an incredible role because they have a place to stay while they come here.
Victor, which birds would we see both in Oregon and here and as migratory?
We have wood thrush.
Okay.
Yeah, Wilson's warbler. Tennessee, Canada, many of the warblers that come here. Cedar waxwing is probably the one you are more familiar with.
Oh, definitely, yeah, I've seen
it
those in my garden.
They come all the way here.
Victor, today Garden Time is on a tour with Colette Tours, and so we came here to the area, your refuge here, and we actually did something today.
Yeah, something very important, which is plant a tree.
Just one tree.
One tree. One tree. One tree makes the difference.
Mm.
Yeah. One tree after another tree, another, and hundreds of trees. Then we create beautiful forests like this. And the donation that it comes through Colette Vacation Foundation from this group, we plant many trees in May when the rainy season comes.
In the right time.
Yeah, in the right time. Now because Victor has to water the trees. So, yeah. So,
we want to make your job as easy as possible.
I can't water 100 trees.
That's right. So if people want to help, is there a way that we can get in touch with you?
Yeah, well, through Children Change the World Kids. Change the World Kids is in Woodstock, Vermont. They raise money for this organization. They come every year here, and they bring the donation, and they come and plant a lot of trees in June.
Wonderful.
Yeah, and so maybe that will be the easiest way. Change the World Kids in Woodstock, Vermont.
All right.
And of course, through the website, and but probably for you in the States, that would be the easiest way.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, we'll give you all that information. It'll be on gardentime.tv or on the screen, and you could help plant a tree that will really help all the whole world. Thank you so much, Victor.
Thank
Thanks
you.
For all you do.
Thank you very much. Thanks a lot for coming and doing this special event today. Thanks a lot.
Judy, wasn't that a great trip to Costa Rica?
It was so much fun, plus we learned a lot.
You know, and if you'd like to join us on one of our trips, you can go to gardentime.tv because next spring, we're going to Ireland.
And don't forget that the Dahlia Festival at Swan Island Dahlias in Canby is this weekend and next weekend. And for more information, go to gardentime.tv and we'll click you over to that website.
Thanks so much for watching today. We'll do it all again next week, right here on Garden Time.
Garden Time is going to Ireland. Join William and Judy as they tour the Emerald Isle, visiting some outstanding private and public gardens. For more information, go to gardentime.tv and click on the airplane.
Stop and smell a rose, hear a child laugh, see the beauty that is Oregon. You will find all this and more at the Oregon Garden in historic Silverton. 400-year-old oaks, edible landscapes, a children's garden. The Oregon Garden has something for everyone. You can ensure the garden remains a jewel in the Mid-Willamette Valley through your support as an individual, family, or corporate member. Support the garden that showcases the diverse botanical beauty of our state, the Oregon Garden.
The proceeding was a paid program of the Guston Creative Group and its sponsors.